Let's start off with an introduction. Tell us about yourself personally and professionally.
I'm a local from Bay County. I've been here for my whole life, and I've owned my own construction business for the last 29 years. And I coached a lot of football and baseball, and been very involved with the kids of this community. And I'm passionate about this position. I'm doing it for all the right reasons. I have no hidden agenda. I just really want to see this community do, you know, well in the future, because I've got five kids, and two daughters by my fiance, my fiance's got two daughters, and so between us, we got seven kids that are going to be having grandchildren and stuff, you know, and we just want to make sure that, you know, Bay County is going to be the place they want to stay. And
is that what made you decide to run for office?
Yeah, that, and I had a couple builder buddies of mine come by, and I will say all my competitors are pretty much support me 100%, which is a compliment. And they just thought that, you know, with me doing business in this community for almost the last 30 years, and everybody likes me and I like everybody, and it being on the presidential ballot, that everybody's going to come out and vote, and I know a lot of people. So
what do you build? Do you build houses, or?
I build anything from a doghouse to a condominium. It doesn't matter. I hold the biggest license you get in the state of Florida. So when I got my license, the boom was going on. And the age I got it at, most of my friends were building houses and, you know, first time home builders. And I didn't get this license to be a residential builder, but it's just kind of the way I fell into it. And we do small commercial and stuff like that.
Okay. Let's talk about priorities if elected. What would your priorities be?
There's a lot. You know, I worry about the kids of the community. I feel like you only get out, I always tell my kids, you only get out what you put in. And I just feel like we're not investing enough in our children. And they go off to college, and then they get in a town where they see where things are pretty, and or they're on campuses that are beautiful. And my worry is that they're not going to come back. And then obviously you want your kids to come back and have your grandbabies, and you know, y'all can all be here together. And so I want to make sure that we're doing the right things to protect our kids, and to make sure that there's you know, extracurricular activities that they can do. My question is to a lot of people that have young kids or grandkids, is if you wanted to go out on a Friday or Saturday night, and I'm not talking about to go out to dinner, because the kids don't care about that. They want to go out and do something fun. Well, by the time we work Monday through Friday, we're all tired as adults, and the older you get, the more tired you get. And so I ask them, what would you do? And they look at me and they think, and they their answer is nothing. There's nothing to do between the Hathaway Bridge and the Tyndall Bridge. And so I want to see things that us here in town can do with our kids or grandkids, and not have to go out there and fight the tourists and
Well, let's talk about attracting businesses, because that's what gets our kids and our grandkids to stay. How would you attract businesses, and would you believe in offering incentives?
Most definitely. First of all, I think we need to offer the companies here that are here now and make sure, and they could be, I don't know, but the people that employ, you know, say 100 people, I don't know, I'd have to, you know, I haven't, it, this has been a real busy time. So I haven't had a chance to research everything, but you know, if you employ 100 people, let's take care of the local businesses first, and then we go after the bigger companies to come in to definitely offer them incentives, tax breaks, whatever we need to do to bring their business here.
Let's talk a little bit about Hurricane Michael. It's been 2 years, but we're still recovering. Some folks haven't recovered at all yet. As a county commissioner, what would you do to move that process along quicker?
Well, I was in an interview with the Board of Realtors, and I told them, and this is not to be anything taken the wrong way, I felt like our local government could have been a lot more informative, because me being in the construction business, I know just about everybody I dealt with got taken advantage of. And I think if we would have been more instructed, you know, during that time, people would have, you know, made better decisions and not been so hasty. And to be honest with you, I've seen a lot in my life, and that was probably the worst I've ever seen. It was terrible. I feel sorry for the people of this community. And then you had the COVID right in behind it. I worry about the mental state of the people here in this town.
Well, let's talk about COVID. How do you think county commissioners, the current board, did handling it, and would you do anything different?
Well, they did what they were supposed to. I you know, hurricanes is something that we deal with as a state of, in the state of Florida, and you know, all along the coast. This COVID was something that none of us have dealt with. So I feel like they did the best that they could under the circumstances. I there was no handbook for that, for sure. Right. It was a
pardon me, I'm losing my voice.
That's okay.
Let's talk about trust. The FBI has an investigation going on into alleged corruption in Bay County, and that's why District 4 is open, because the man who had the job is no longer there. Pardon me. Why should people trust you? Like, why do you think that's important, and what do you say to folks who don't know you, maybe?
Well, the people that know me definitely trust me. That's why they're supporting me. They've been lifelong friends. The ones that don't know me, you'll have to trust me, and I know that's a big word. You got to trust somebody. You got to elect somebody and trust them. And I would absolutely say that I'm your best bet.
Okay. Over the years, there have been these private dinners, men only, in District 4, coincidentally enough, most of them. Have you ever attended one of those meetings, or those dinners? I'm sorry, it's a dinner. Have you ever been to one of those?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Well, you know that this year it seems to have become a point of contention with some voters. It looks like there may be, you know, the looks of impropriety, and perception is reality. If you were elected and then invited, would you still go?
Most definitely. Let me tell you something. Derwin White, I've known him pretty much my whole life. We played softball together. We've hunted together. And this is what I tell people about Derwin. I don't know his personal business, but I know this. If you come to him, and I don't care who it is in Bay County, that he will absolutely help people. I know James Finch has flown to many of people. I don't really know him, but I went to school with his daughters. And you know, this is what I tell people. You know, I've got five kids, and I hope that you can judge my character by my kids. I've raised five good, wonderful kids, and James's daughters are as good as people as you ever met. And I've not come to them about any of this. I'm the only candidate that's not asked Derwin for money. He told me that personally. And so, you know, I'm here. I don't care if you're poor, Democrat, Republican. Nothing of that matters. If you elect me, I'm gonna be different. I'm working for you. If you need something, you can call me. I don't care who you are. I mean, I'm gonna help whoever, whenever, and I will have my number out there. It's posted on every website. I have no problem coming to anybody's needs or helping anybody. That's as a county commissioner, I feel like where we went wrong is that, you know, it's not about me. It's about you and this whole audience out here. If y'all, I'll tell you my phone number right now. It's 850-866-1116. If you need me, you can call me anytime, and I will help you.
Well, that gets us to the point of transparency. Every candidate, every politician says, I'm going to be transparent. What does that mean to you?
I'm not a politician, so... transparency. I don't know what they're talking about, to be honest with you. I mean, a lot of people know me in this town, and they absolutely know my heart. And and I'm doing this for, I promise you, I make way more money. I've been my own boss. It's not a power trip for me. It's only for the good of the community is why I'm running.
Let's talk about the campaign a little bit. You mentioned Derwin White, who I don't know. But when it comes to campaign money, you have about $7,000 in your fund right now?
I'm up to about 20-something thousand.
Are you up to that much?
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't see that when I checked today. Have you received any donations from any companies or big corporations that might do business with the county that could be seen as a conflict of interest?
Absolutely not. My guys that I've been in construction for almost 30 years now, and it's the people that I deal with, the suppliers, the subcontractors, friends of mine. It's been, I mean, people have, you know, $40, $50 contributions. It's been, I've been blessed. And I've been working hard because I take that very seriously. I have a hard time asking for money because if I want money, I'll work harder. You know, I'll work Saturday and Sunday if I need
extra money. $20,000 is a pretty good pot campaign. That puts you second in the list.
Yeah.
As far as I know, from all the candidates.
And then, you know, I take that very personally because I'm one of these guys. If I'm going to do something, I'm going to give it 110%. And I like to be successful. I don't care if I play in checkers. This is my motto. I want to beat you.
All right. So if a company came to you and said, hey, I'm going to give you money for your campaign between now and the election day, you would turn it down? A company that could do business with the county in the future?
I haven't sought after anybody, and I don't feel like anybody's coming right at this point to come, you know, give me any money. But if they did, it depends on, you know, the circumstances. I'm not taking... I promise you, I'm honest, and if I felt like it was wrong, I wouldn't take it.
There are guidelines that the state provides for candidates once you're elected. Have you looked at those ethics guidelines yet? It's like a class that you'll have to take.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty much common sense. I mean, I don't think it's Chinese arithmetic. I've done business in this town my whole life, just about, or you know, my adult life, I've made it this far without having anybody question me ever about doing anything wrong. And especially during the Hurricane Michael, you'd be surprised at the people that ask you to do things that could be considered insurance fraud. And I just tell them I just don't do that. I mean,
because of the way the seat came open with the FBI investigation and voters feeling like they've been surprised by some of the people who have been charged. That brings us to the question of your character and all that. And I've asked the same question of everybody. Have you ever had a run-in with the law or been arrested?
Yeah. And listen, the people that know me know that, you know, it's been when I was young and stupid. It doesn't mean anything other than I know there's consequences if you make mistakes, and that I'm an open book. There's nothing I can't relate to or haven't probably already dealt with, and I can promise you this: I'm claustrophobic, and you don't have to worry about me coming out in silver bracelets. I can assure you that.
But 5 years ago, you had a felony charge. You were an adult 5 years ago.
Yeah.
Can you elaborate on that or explain what it is?
Well...
Or why you don't think it's important to voters?
Well, because it got thrown out. I mean, you know, I never even had to go to the court. I never had to go to the courthouse or nothing. You know, when people are upset, they do, they make... they're always the victim. You know, this is what I tell you. Anytime you get in a fight with somebody, and most of the times I've ever fought for has been because I was taken up for other people. And, I've been threatened and threatened and threatened. And then when the case you're referring to, the guy that was threatening me, I told him, so you're not going to call the law when I whip you. And he said, No, I mean, you know, he told me how big and tough he was and all that. Well, when I did, he called the law. So, I mean, I own up to anything that I've ever done. And if I was guilty, I was guilty. And if I wasn't, I wasn't. And if I wasn't, I got the charges got thrown out. So,
all right. Do you currently live in District 4?
Mm-hmm.
Or you do? Have you lived there a long time?
I say 95% because I don't want to be a liar. Probably about 99% of the 49 years I've been here have been in District 4. But I don't like to, you know, I lessened it just to make sure that somebody said, well, you know, I did the math. You did, you know, you were only 90% of your life.
But so. You live there now.
Yeah, I've always lived there.
Okay.
Yeah. I grew up in Cherokee Heights when it was a sod farm. There was no schools, and it was it wasn't even Cherokee Heights subdivision. It was just Cherokee Heights Road, Frank Huff right. Road, and all that stuff. So,
have you ever been in a county commission meeting?
I've been watching them. The problem is with the county commissioners meeting that, and this is for all of us. I watched the videos, and I encourage people to come because there's nobody there, so there's no eyes on the commissioners if I was elected and the other guys. There's no eyes on them to really keep them accountable, and I encourage people, they need to go. But the problem is most of us have all got jobs and, you know, we're super busy.
Well, are you going to be able to go if you're elected?
Oh, yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
just checking.
Most definitely.
Do you know what the budget is?
I've looked over it. I guess I've been watching the commission meetings, and I've looked over the things. And you know, one of my concerns is that, you know, we shut the incinerator down, and you know, I trust the guys that are in there. But it's affected the people's trash service out there. I mean, you got to figure when you're in Bayou George and you can go to the incinerator, and even the guy that owns the company that's picking up your trash, God bless them, how quick is it to run to the incinerator and dump it versus, you know, the man hours, the wear and tear on your truck, you know, the time that it takes you to drive to Steelfield. And you know, and I don't know the demographics of Steelfield. I hunted up there. I've been to Steelfield, and you know, I figure one of them condos alone, you know, produces a ton of trash. I mean, I just don't know.
Would you like to have seen the incinerator stay open? I said they were losing millions of dollars.
Well, I've had friends at work out there that tell me, you know, different. You know, we bought and sold it, and I don't know that. If we've, you know, when we sold it, did they maintain it correctly, or did they not? I don't know. I mean, if they're paying to dump trash there and we're burning it, I mean, like I said, I don't know all the ins and outs. I mean, I'm sure they made the best interest on that decision to the community. I just worry about the longevity of the trash. I mean, you got to get rid of it. I mean, if you're not burning it, you're burying it. So. I don't know how long Steelfield can stay open with all the trash of Bay County going there. So.
Well, final question, why should voters choose you?
Well, I feel like I'm your best bet. I don't mean to sound arrogant when I say that, but and I wanted to say this, and I haven't had a chance, but the five guys that are running against me, man, to do this in 10 weeks is a lot of work, and they have had to really, really, it affects your marriage, your family, your social life, your kids, and hats off to all of them, because I don't think anybody realizes how much work it goes into this. And, you know, and I've did some research, this is an interesting fact. I can't find in the history of Bay County that there's ever been six candidates for one position. And then a friend of mine that I was talking to, he said he hasn't found anywhere in the United States that there's been six candidates for one seat. So it's kind of interesting facts, but it's been a lot of work, and I'm working hard, and I always work hard. So the people that when they get me, they're gonna get somebody honest with some backbone. I'm gonna vote for the best interest of the community, and I just think that I'm the best bet. I don't mean that in any other than a humble way. I mean,
You have experience.
I have experience. I've dealt with any kind of construction, land use, ordinances, code enforcement, building, codes, and I've been here, and I know the concerns of the people. I mean, so this ain't about me. I honestly want the people to know that this is honestly about them. I have nothing to gain. Some buddies of mine said, you know, you got your house on the lake, you got a place in Howard's Creek, got a new boat. I bought a boat and two wave runners in June. I haven't rode one of them. I haven't been, and they've been out in the water. I've been working that hard. And this was ever before I thought about running, but I mean, I like to work, and I want to see our community grow and get better.
All right. Well, we appreciate your time. Thank you for doing this.
Thank you.